Year's X Factor live shows are well underway. The competition has been hotting up.
Well, one man who knows only too well what it feels like to be right in the thick of it is last year's winner, Matt Cardle.
Hey, the guy who's rocked it out since his first audition is Matt Cardle.
I really, really like you. Well, takes over.
Matt joins us now. Man, you are super critical
you
of yourself.
You really are. Mike, he's sitting there going, I can't hear it, I can't
it's
hear it.
It's when you hear it like that, it's you can hear it out of tune. It's always with the yellow trousers.
Oh,
always
I know.
With the trousers.
You regret those, don't you, those yellow trousers?
But it happened. Oh, again.
Sorry. Don't
you mention
it, otherwise we'll flag
you
it
You mention it, we'll show it.
Okay.
It's funny, actually, because when I went to the Extra Factor the other week, and we bumped into each other, I saw you outside, you're about to do your performance.
Yeah.
And that is a scary stage, isn't it? And you were saying, even now, after all you've done, you were still nervous about it.
Yeah, there's just so many people watching, and there's, you know, there's a lot of pressure to get it right. And, you know, for my own worst critic, and I don't think I've ever got, you know, it completely right, and I don't think I ever will, but that's a good thing, I think, to keep getting better.
Well, it's pressure doing that, and that's one thing, but there's also an enormous amount of pressure afterwards and what comes next, what happens to you after you leave X Factor. And you actually took a very brave decision, didn't you? Because you didn't decide to sign exclusively to Simon Cowell's Psycho Company.
Yes,
you decided to actually do it with somebody else.
Yeah.
And your reasons for doing that was because it would give you a little bit more control, and actually the direction where you wanted to take your music was much more as a musician as opposed to pop, I guess.
Yeah, I think I didn't want to go down the pop route, and, you know, Psycho are great at pop, but I'm not a pop person, I don't think. So I think the move to, you know, halfway to Columbia was a good thing.
Mm. And strange as well for you that you, didn't you, when you were 13, send your first demo tape to Columbia?
Oh, we sent them all over the place. I mean, I even bumped into the head of the management company that I'm with now with a CD about 3 years ago when I was running around London. And, you know, that probably went in the bin along with a lot of other demos. But
well, thankfully, finally, you get into the studio. And last summer, I think you went to a studio in Brighton.
Yes, that's right.
So why... I mean, it seems a long time. For anyone who watched you on the final and, yay, fantastic, it seems a long time between then and getting into the studio.
Yeah, the tour goes on till sort of mid-April, nearly, I think. I can remember. It was wicked, wicked fun. But obviously there's a few of us in there that had, you know, pending studio appointments and albums to write. And that takes time. We had plenty of time to do it, but we were kind of itching to get on with it, you know.
And what sort of stuff? It's very personal stuff on the album, isn't
it? There's, you know, it's all kind of life experiences, you know, situations I've got myself into and out of, you know, past relationships, all that kind of thing.
Well, you say yourself, you have been in the past the bad boyfriend.
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh, no.
So that's which is the song on the album that reflects that then?
I think it's
Pull
Across
Me Under,
the Board.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, I think Pull Me Under is one of them, definitely. You know, Beat of a Breaking Heart, all that kind of, you know.
Well, this is the album here. It's called Letters, and it's doing very well. Midweek's number two.
I know, I can't believe it, behind the mighty Noel Gallagher. Yeah, it's just incredible to think that I'm up there.
It's funny because you get a number two album behind Noel Gallagher, and I think you've got a single chance in at number six, but there are still people who say, well, that's, you know, it's not as successful as you would have liked to have been. What do you say to that?
I wouldn't say that's unsuccessful. I mean, for me, if someone had said to me last year that I would have a number two album in the midweek and would have gone in the charts to number six with my single, I would have said, how the hell did that happen? You know,
well,
I think it's incredible.
That's the difference between a real singer-songwriter, isn't it? The album, where the album positions
that's
is
it for
the
me,
most
yeah.
important thing.
Yeah, definitely.
Because that's your art right there.
It's my baby,
that's what
right
you
there.
Made.
Yeah.
And have you been watching this year? I mean, obviously, you were down there last weekend, but have you been keeping
track? Yeah. It's so funny watching it. Just knowing exactly what the guys are going through, you know, the last person that they spoke to before they stepped on the stage, you know, handing you the mic and giving you, you know, all the best in that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And who do you think, a bit unfair to us, but obviously we're going to, who do you think could win it?
I've got a lot of time for Sophie. I think she's great. We haven't seen the best of her yet.
Yeah, she has got a great voice.
Yeah, she's gorgeous as well.
Is that the real reason you're backing her?
No, I think she's incredibly talented as well. I mean, she's a really sweet girl from what I've heard and when I met her. Yeah. Craig's great, and The Risk are doing brilliantly as well for a band that have been put together, you know?
Well, The Risk could... A lot of people are saying that The Risk could very well take over from Westlife, you know, now.
Really?
Yeah,
but they, you know, there's a sort of stall... A lot
Gosh,
of stall
there's even
work.
More of a gap in the boy band market, isn't there?
Are you busking on the streets next week in London?
It's, later today.
Is it today?
Yeah.
So, and what is that for?
It's for the big issue.
So
the piece we did with them. Carnaby Street.
Brilliant. Okay.
That should be fun.
Nice.
I've busked before. Didn't make a lot of money, but. You know.
£6. You made £6 in half an hour, didn't you?
It was £8.
£8 half an hour. Well, you can't sniff
£16 an hour is pretty damn good.
I think you've got a feeling you're making a bit more today.
Well, we mentioned The Risk, we mentioned Westlife, and of course we talked about them at the beginning of the show, and the fact that that Westlife have said that they are going to split up. So I thought what we would do is just celebrate that moment as we are on stools.
Yes, boys. Thank you for the music. In honour of you, Eamon and Ruth have got Chantal Halton and Alex Reid popping in tomorrow, along with comedian Bill Bailey. Have you got my stool?
Yeah, that's absolutely fine. We'll just tidy up and pick our stuff up.
No worries.
We'll leave that one there.
That's
all right. You're right with that one?
Yeah.
Matt, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, guys.
Absolutely lovely to see you. So busking today, and we will we'll leave you with a special acoustic version of his track "All for Nothing," last year's winners of the X Factor. It's Matt Cardle.
Use your eyes, oh Father, 'cause I had a dream last night. I saw her body broke, still and cold, where she lay, and it was all we made. And I pray you keep her safe, bring her home, keep her away. And I pray you don't let me down, bring her back, 'cause I need her now. I pray someone else can take her place, 'cause falling in love is like playing with fire. It's pulling me down, it's taking me higher. I know it's my fault when I'm asking for favors. I needed a knife, but you gave me the razor. I pray you keep her safe, bring her home, keep her away. And I pray a place. Don't make it all for nothing, the love we made.
Well, if you fancy watching Matt's performance again, or anything from the show from the last 7 days, ITV Player is just what you need at itv.com/ITV Player. And Matt Goss is on Loose Women next.